Hello there, and welcome back to Math Hacks. Today, we are expanding on our knowledge of completing the square by using it to transform quadratics from standard form to vertex form so that we can easily graph them on an XY coordinate plane. By the end of today's lesson, you'll have all the tools that you need to not only graph any quadratic, but also to easily identify the vertex and the stretch of a parabola simply by looking at the equation. Let's get started. Today, you are going to learn how to graph a parabola using the vertex form of the equation, and we are going to begin by graphing the equation y equals x squared plus 10x plus 20. But before we get started, we need to know a couple things. One of the things we need to know is the graph of the parent function. So when I'm talking about the parent function, I'm talking about the function that is the most basic form of this equation. So in this case, we want to know what the graph of y equals x squared looks like. So y equals x squared is the parabola that sits on the origin. So its vertex is at 0, 0. And then what you need to know about it is that it is a U-shape that opens upward. And there's just a couple points that you really need to have memorized. Now, the next set of points that I'm going to graph for the y equals x squared is just going over 1 on either side. So when I plug in a value of x equals 1, 1 squared is 1, so I'm going to get a positive 1 out. When I plug in negative 1, negative 1 squared is also positive 1, so I'm going to get a positive 1 here. So from the origin, my standard parabola is always going to go over 1, up 1, over 1, up 1. Now let's plug in 2 and negative 2. So when I plug in x equals positive 2, 2 squared is 4, so I get a y value of 4. And likewise, when I plug in negative 2, negative 2 squared is 4, so I also get a y value of 4. So the points that you need to remember for the parent function of a parabola is from the origin, you can go over 1 and up 1 in either direction. And then you can also go over 2 and up 4 from either direction. And connecting those dots, we get this nice parabola shape. And that is our parent function. So to graph y equals x squared plus 10x plus 20, the first thing I need to do is complete the square. Completing the square will ensure that my equation is in vertex form. This here is vertex form, sometimes referred to also as standard form, but vertex form is probably the best descriptor of it because the most important thing that the equation in this form shows us is where the vertex is. And the vertex is the values in the places of h and k in our equation. So our vertex will be hk. This also tells us whether our parabola is being stretched, compressed, or flipped. And all that information is stored in the coefficient outside of this x minus h squared term. So where this a is what's going to tell you whether you need to stretch your parabola, compress your parabola, or even flip it upside down. And I'm going to show you what that looks like in a couple of our examples today. But first, let's get started with this pretty straightforward example. The first thing I'm going to do is complete the square. If you need a recap on how to complete the square, I have another tutorial covering that, so go check it out. Once I get my equation in vertex form, it's really easy for me to be able to read off what the vertex is. So in this problem, I have y equals x plus 5 all squared minus 5. The values in this position and this position are the h and k, or the vertex. So the important thing to note here is that in our vertex form, we have x minus h. And that minus sign is really important because what it means is that this is really x minus negative 5. That's how I'm going to get the plus 5 here. Or in other words, you can think of the x value of our vertex is always the opposite sign of what shows up here. So if it has a plus 5 here, you can think of it as a negative 5. If it were a negative 5, then it would just simply be a plus 5 in the x value. The y coordinate of our vertex, or the k value, has a plus sign here. So it is simply just the number you would see on the end. So that means the vertex for this equation is negative 5, negative 5. And because we don't have a coefficient written outside of our parentheses, that means that a simply is 1. And if a is 1, that means it's just the same as our standard parabola. It's not flipped, it's not stretched, it's not compressed. So it makes things really nice and easy. Now let's go ahead and graph this. So the first thing I want to do is plot the vertex on my xy coordinate axis. So I'm going to go left 5 and down 5. Now I'm simply going to follow the pattern of our parent function since I know that this parabola isn't stretched, compressed, or flipped. So from the vertex, I'm going to go over 1, up 1 on both sides. And then also from the vertex, I can go over 2 and up 4. And that's enough points to get the idea of what our parabola looks like, so I'm just going to connect the dots with a smooth curve. So to begin this problem, I am going to start by completing the square. Now remember, when you're completing the square, if you have something other than positive 1 as your coefficient on the x squared term, make sure that in the second step you factor that out of your parentheses. Now here it's important to remember that when I take half of the middle term squared, in this case negative 2 squared, which is 4, I have to also subtract it from the outside. But because I have this negative 1 being multiplied, I'm really subtracting negative 1 times negative 2 squared, or positive 4. So make sure that you multiply whatever it was you added here when you subtract that value off. All right, so now that I have this equation in vertex form, I am going to go ahead and draw my xy coordinate axis and graph it. And before I get started there, let's make a note of what the vertex is. So remember, it is the opposite of this sign. So instead of a negative 2, it will be a plus 2 for the x coordinate. And then it'll be the same as on the outside for our y coordinate. So that's positive 1. So this time, our parabola has a vertex at 2, positive 1, and we do have an a value this time. So this here is a, and when a is a negative number, it means that our parabola is upside down. So we have a parabola that is concave down in this problem. Now, because it's just a 1, it's not stretched or compressed. It still maintains the same proportions. It's just going to be upside down. So I'm going to apply the vertex first at positive 2, positive 1. And now I'm going to do the parabola facing downwards, and I'm going to maintain the same proportion. So that means from the vertex, I can go 1 in either direction, but instead of going up 1, I'm going to go down 1. And then also from the vertex, I can go over 2 and down 4. Over 2 and down 4. Once you have those points, you can connect the dots. Again, for this first problem, let's start by completing the square. Notice that once again we have a coefficient other than 1 on our x squared term, so in the second step I'm going to make sure to factor that out. Once again, I made sure that because I had this 3 factored out, when I went to balance my equation, I made sure to multiply my negative 1 squared by 3 and subtract it from negative 1. So once I've completed the square, I have y equals 3 times x minus 1 squared minus 4. Now this means that my vertex is at positive 1, negative 4, and the 3 in the position of A means that my parabola is going to be stretched by a factor of 3, and I'll show you how to handle that in this graph. So starting with the vertex, I'm going to plot it at 1, negative 4. Next, I am going to fill in the parabola. This time, the proportion is changing, though, and it's going to be changed by a factor of 3. So instead of going over 1 and up 1, I'm going to go over 1 and up 1 times 3. So over 1 and up 3. And if you wanted to do the next point, you would go over 2, and instead of going up 4, you would go up 4 times 3, so you would go up 12. Because that's going to be way up here on the graph, I'm not going to bother to do those two points, but you can see how much skinnier and stretched out this parabola has become when we had that factor of 3 on the outside. In our final problem today, we are going to be graphing the equation y equals 2x squared plus 5x plus 1. And I'm going to do that using vertex form once again. So I'll begin by completing the square. And notice that we have a 2 in front of the x squared term. So that means that in the second step, I'm going to have to factor out 2. Now in this problem, that's going to leave some fractions for us to work with, so it makes it a little bit more tricky, but don't worry, I'll walk you through each step that I'm doing to show you how you can handle the problems when they get a little messier. Now in this third step, I am factoring out the 2. So basically, that's the same as dividing both of these terms by 2. So 2x squared divided by 2 is just x squared, which is nice and easy. But 5x divided by 2 obviously is a fraction. So you have a choice of writing this as 2.5 or 5/2. For the time being, I'm just going to write it as 5/2x. Now for the third step, remember we need to take 1/2 of the middle term and square it. So I'm going to do a little scratch work on the side here. I need to take 5/2 and divide it by 2. Now remember, when I take a fraction and I divide it, that's the same as flipping and multiplying. So this turns out to be the same as 5/2 times 1/2, which is 5/4. And of course, I'm going to square that. And for the time being, I'm just going to put parentheses around it and square it like this. Remember, what I add to the inside, I need to subtract from the outside. So I'm going to subtract 5/4 squared. Remember, it is being multiplied by 2 though, so I really need to subtract off 2 times 5/4 squared. Now I'm going to show you a little shortcut here. If you just write the number that you add in the blank like I did here with half of the middle term, and then instead of squaring it out, just writing a little power of 2 on it, how it will always work out is that the number that you add or subtract to x when you factor it will turn out to be the number that was being squared here. I can already tell you that the number I'm going to have in my factorization is going to be x plus 5/4. And if you look back at all the problems we've done so far, you'll see that the number that was added or subtracted inside the binomial turns out to be the same number that we squared and added in the blank. And then I have a bit of arithmetic here to figure out the constant. So I have 1 minus 2 times 5/4 squared. And I'm just going to go over here to the side and do that since I'm running out of room. The first thing I want to do is square this. So I'm going to have 5 squared over 4 squared, which is the same as 25 over 16. This is being multiplied by 2, which is the same as 2 over 1, and then subtracted from 1. In this case, I can cross cancel since 2 goes into 16 8 times. So I'm going to divide both of those by 2. And then I get 25 over 8 here. Lastly, I just need to subtract these. To subtract 25 eighths from 1, I want to make a common denominator. So I'm going to rewrite 1 as 8 over 8. And then I can do 8 minus 25, which is negative 17 over 8. So I can either leave that as an improper fraction, or if it's more useful to you to think of as a mixed number, 8 goes into 17 2 times with 1 left over. So this is negative 2 and 1 eighth. And I'll go ahead and simplify this down. Lastly, I see that my vertex is at negative 5/4 or negative 1 and 1/4 and negative 2 and 1 eighth. I went ahead and just wrote those as mixed numbers because I think when we go to graph it, it's just a little easier to understand with mixed numbers. Lastly, my parabola is being stretched by a factor of 2. So my stretch is 2. Okay, so our final step is to graph this. I'm going to go ahead and draw my axes. I'll plot my vertex, and I'm just going to approximate as closely as I can to get to negative 1 and 1/4 and negative 2 and 1 eighth. Now I'm going to fill in the points on my parabola, but I am going to change the proportion so that it is multiplied by a factor of 2. So normally I would go over 1 in each direction and up 1. This time I'll go over 1 and up 1 times 2, so up 2. That'll put me about here on this side. And then also from the vertex, my standard proportion is to go over 2 and then go up 4. This time I will go over 2 and I will go up 2 times 4, so up 8. And that ends up being way up here, almost back in my equation. And now I'll do that for the other side. Okay, so as you can tell, this parabola has been stretched by a factor of 2. That kind of looks cool. It's kind of like my parabola has infiltrated my math. Remember, there are a whole bunch of Algebra 1 and 2 tutorials over on my channel. So if you need more math help, go on over there and check it out. And while you're there, don't forget to click that subscribe button to get more math hacks in your feed. Till next time, I'm Brett, and thank you so much for joining me.